Hello guys, welcome back to your Code Academy channel. In this video, we are going to talk about how to test perform all your CRUD operations, that is a create, read, update and delete in your web API. Doing that in Visual Studio and how to debug it with HTTP file without using Swagger UI. When you create CRUD operations in web API, definitely you have to run the application to test it using the Swagger. But there's a new way to do that. You can use an HTTP file to do that instead of using the Swagger. And that is what we are going to talk about today. This is going to be a short video and it is showing the trick or how to get it done quicker than using or other time running your application. Now, I know when you create your API, if you want to test the API, unless you run the application. So if you want to test anything, then you have to be run all the application. But there's a way to handle that testing without running the application. Now, when you check this project, I have created a web API project over here. And now, so I'm going to run. The traditional way of running or testing web API here, it is to click on the button to run it in the browser. And now when it runs it, we have a UI that is known as Swagger. So that is what it's going to give us. Or we have all the CRUD operations, or we have all the methods in our controller over here. And within here, you can decide to get data, or you can decide to delete data, and also update, perform all the CRUD operation as well. But you know, instead of all the time running this, if we update anything, instead of running this to test, you can use a simple way to do it. And that is what we are going to take a look. So with this, we're not going to talk much about this because I know this, you know it already. Let's talk about the other one, that the new way to handle the same testing, API testing, without using Swagger UI. Let's go to our Visual Studio. Now, in our Visual Studio, we are going to create a new file here. So, this is a Visual Studio. So, if I go to Solution Explorer, you can see I have all my project architecture over here. Now, I'm going to create a new folder here. So, right click on the project and I'm going to create a new. So before that, let me close the debugging. So right click on this project and then click on add. We're going to add a new folder, and maybe the name of this folder that we are going to create, you can set it as, well, any name at all. So let's see. This is HTTP file. So that is HTTP files. So right click on this folder and now click on add, then new item. Okay, so click on this new item. Now when the template loads, what you need to do here is to go to this. Click on, you can click on general or C sharp, and now click here and I'll type in HTTP. So HTTP, you're gonna have this HTTP file, a file containing HTTP and REST request. That's a RESTful service request. So this name, we can name it as customer HTTP. Now you can see that the extension here, it is .http, so keep that and now click on add. So now we have one HTTP file created in a folder known as HTTP files folder. Okay, so with this, that is where we are going to perform all our CRUD operation. We're going to test our application. So without running all the time, running, you can execute commands straight to test your API within the Visual Studio without running your application. And that is very good. It is a nice thing that Visual Studio, the community team has added to this. Let's try that and see. So if you want to get more information about how to use HTTP files, maybe you can just go to aka.ms slash vs, then click the add HTTP file. But you know, I'm going to give you some sample short idea on how to get it. Okay, so even without reading that, you can still have something small here. But if you want to get a wide range of knowledge, you can just go there and I'll try to read something about or more about what we are doing here. So let's see. Now what we need to do here is there's something that you need to know, because as soon as I click on the spacebar or the enter key, you will see I have all the CRUD operations here: delete, get, head, options, patch, post, put, and trace. Okay, so when I'm done, so let's first use the get. Now I know in HTTP web, as soon as we see get, it means you want to get something from the API. Now what you have to do here is we have to now run application in the Swagger mode so we can grab the URI. Okay, that's the base URI. So let's run this application to grab the base URI, and now we test it over here. So instead of running our UI, Swagger UI, no, we're not going to do that. We're going to do everything here. Perform all the CRUD operation, delete, update, create, read, everything. So let's run this, then let's grab the, yeah, that's the UI here. So I'm gonna grab this. So grab the UI, and now you can stop it. So I can stop this, because I have the UI here. Now I'm gonna put it over here like this. So get, then put the URI here. The API name is what, API slash customer. Now as soon as you done type, because we have send request, we have this button. Now as soon as I click on this button, see what happens here. So let's see, it is running this request, and now it's going to get us a list of the data that we have in the application. That's an API. Now here we have 504 internal error. Let's see API slash customer. So let's check our endpoint to see the API. Well, so here that is a 7185 for our URI. Then we check our endpoint here, and on this endpoint API slash customer, so yeah, okay, please wait for an editor command to finish. Just copying at time. That is what happens when your machine has a lot of loads to carry. So API same over here, API slash customer. So run this request again. Let's see the response coming in. So let's see what we can do here to solve this issue. Oh, okay, so let's see. All right, so we have to run application. Like you see, we have an error here because you haven't not found, because application is not currently running, our server is not running. So let's run it. Click on this to run it. So whilst it runs the server, you can see this is what we need. So you can see here it is not running, and now let's go in there and execute and see what we're gonna have now. Well, so you can see we have the data here, and that is, we have only one data. So if you check this, as soon as I click on get, try this out and execute, so I have one data here. Okay, let's try to post here. So I'm gonna copy, there is a post, try this out, and now let's post the as customer 2, and address is street 34M. Phone number is, so execute this. Let's copy this here. So we see we have this connected or created. When it go to execute, we have 2. Now let's go to HTTP file here and I execute the same because we have 2, right? That is a get. So if you want to have the next command line, space here, and I use pound key 3 times, then we can now go for, let's go for post. So post, then let's put this here. So we're gonna grab this. You can grab this and then put this here. Now the next thing that you have to do here is click here, and now you're gonna type in content type, then you say that's application or JSON format. Because when you check the API here, you can see the content type is here. When you check, let's check the header. You can see we have it is accepting applications like JSON. So this is what you need to specify here. And that's what you've done. Now when you're done, leave a space in between like this. Then since post you don't need an ID, and now this is customer 3. Okay. 74, and let's say we have this. So execute this, and so you can see it added. Now get this. So you can see we have 3, right? Let's update the same thing. So I'm going to copy this. So 1, 2, 3. Then this is one update. So this is going to be put, and I'm going to specify customer 4. Now this customer 4, I want to change this customer 3 to customer 3 updated street M updated. Okay, now let's execute this and see what happens. Okay, so you have a problem here. Let's check. Okay, status code is okay. Now let's run it and see. Yeah, so you see we have customer 3 updated, street 4 updated. Now let's delete this too. So I always want to grab this, the header. So delete, put pound key 3, then paste this here. So instead of put, you're gonna have delete, passing the ID, and now the ID here gonna be 2. So execute this, and status as well, okay. Now run this application, you can see it is off. Okay, now in order to specify all this, you know one thing, we can also create variables here. How do you create variables? Now you can create variables by using this key, so at. Okay, so let's specify the route here. So instead of this, you want to say at URI, okay, is equal to, then let's grab this, or we can grab this. So let's cut this and now paste this here. So in here, let's see what we can do. We can specify here and you can say URI, but to do that you must also specify another one inside here like this. Then let's say URI. So URI slash API slash custom. It means you are calling this variable. Now let's see. You see we still have the same data, right? Maybe let's see. Let's try to post this 7. So post. Now let's get all. We see we have it. So we can also create variables here. So instead of post like this, you can now clear all this. Then you're gonna say URI. So URI, yes, like this. Then you can now push like this. Also, when we get to, we can specify at ID, okay, is equal to, so let's specify ID as 3 now. Now, when we get to this, we can say, so let's pass in the variable, then we say URI. Then when we get to the variable here, we need to specify the ID. We say ID. And now customer 7 updated. So this customer 7 updated. Now execute this. And now get all. You can see, so this customer 7. Okay, updated. Now you see, because the ID here, it is 3. So we see this is working. So we can specify this. The last thing left here is, if you don't want to be typing, there's also a way to do that. Go to choose, and I'll go to options. So after options, check for environment, and now go for preview features, and I'll make sure you have web API selected. So where is it? It's around here, W column. So make sure you have Web API Endpoint Explorer selected. So select, check this, click on OK. When you are done, come to Views, then Other Window, then go for Endpoint Explorer. That is it. So you see we have Get, Post, Get, Put, Delete, and Get. Now we can clear this like this. We can clear all this. Let's go to get, right click, and then click on generate request. So we see it has stored it over here, and I record a request here. Run, we have everything. Now we can just right click, post, generate request. So push over here. What you need to do is to specify your content type like this, and content type, you say application/JSON. Then specify whatever thing that you want to send. Okay, so you make sure you have it, like the name, the ID. So this is the name, and you specify the name like as you've been doing. So this, you can just grab a copy of this, then you can just paste it here like this. Clear this. ID is not needed. So customer, let's say 9, and I can just hit on it, and you can see it has created. Now the next thing is, you can now get by ID. So generate this. Now you see this is an ID. So this is what you're going to do. You can specify ID here, or you can pass in the ID to this as maybe 5. Run it, and I have only ID as 5. Now you can go for delete, put, and etc. Okay, so you see, without using the API, that is the Swagger, you can still test your API using the HTTP file. I believe this is clear. Thank you guys for watching. If you like what I'm doing, give me a thumbs up, comment, and also share to people as well, in case you have the chance to do that. Thank you, and I'm going to see you in the next video to talk about a different thing altogether, which is going to help us in the programming environment.